I can't even believe this is happening right now.
It's happening, Tim.
What's happening?
Mike, we have a surprise.
We have a car that a lot of people thought we sold and got rid of, that it has 500 horsepower.
What?
And it's been missing for 3 years.
Four years.
We've been trying to find it, and we finally found it. And today, we actually just got the green light that we can go and recover it. There's a story. There's a backstory. We're going to let you guys know about all that. But first, let's go and get this car for these guys.
I'm actually...
They're going to freak out if they see this car back on the channel. I'm excited.
I don't even know what it is. So I'm excited too.
I can't tell you.
Hey Mark, we gotta talk about performance. Hey Mark.
Oh hey Dave.
We gotta talk about your performance for a second. The way you work, it's pretty good. Unfortunately, there's one big problem.
What, dude, what?
It's your personal hygiene. You know, recently, you've been on camera a lot, and people are noticing things. In fact, people are zooming in, and there's one big issue.
These nose hairs, and that's why I say this video is sponsored by Manscaped. Mark, this is Manscaped's brand new Weedbacker 2.0 nose and ear hair trimmer. It features skin-safe technology, so it's not gonna hurt, cut, or nick you.
Nice and gentle, Mark. Just like, oh my god. Ooh. Oh.
All right, right?
Hey.
Feels good.
Okay.
He likes
hey,
it.
Hey, keep doing that.
All right, got you, buddy. And when we're done with your nose, go straight to the ear. The Weedbacker 2.0 is cordless, rechargeable, and has a battery life up to 45 minutes of runtime. When you select the Peak Hygiene Plan with a purchase, you'll receive a replaceable blade every 3 months delivered straight to your door. So when you're whacking, you're keeping it clean. Also, the Weedbacker 2.0 will be in all Manscaped's tool sets, including the Platinum Package 4.0 and the Performance Package 4.0. So no matter what kit you pick, you'll receive the new Weedbacker 2.0 nose and ear hair trimmer. Let's face it, you guys, long nose hair is a major turnoff. So let's Manscaped the best part of your body, your nose. It also smells and looks good. Also holds up Mark's glasses. It's time to level up your groom game with a Weedbacker 2.0 nose and ear hair trimmer. Go to manscaped.com today and get 20% off plus free international shipping when you use promo code DDE at checkout. Bam, Mark, you're good to go. Get back to work. Thank you, Manscaped, for sponsoring today's video. This is the brand new Weedbacker 2.0. The best part, free international shipping plus 20% off. All you have to do is use code DDE at checkout. Grab yours now, Mark. Trim the edit.
Okay, guys, we are going in the Street Evo. Quickly pick up some safety stuff, and then we're gonna meet up with the boys. Stay tuned. I can't believe this car is coming back into our lives.
Sometimes we're guilty of not explaining where cars go. It's happened a few times. This car in particular, and honestly, we didn't know what to say. We're gonna get the car today. Now, we have to tow it. I don't know if it runs. I doubt it does. Plus, there's no insurance on the car. We're not gonna play any games, put it on the trailer properly, strap it properly, and get it back to the shop to figure out what's next. Does it have damage we don't know about? I bet you it does. It's been stored now, pretty sure outside, for 4 years. All right, we're here for a trailer. All right, let's load up. I have no idea what I'm doing. All right. All right, we're locked and loaded. Thanks to U-Haul for the trailer. It's actually a really good deal. It's like $75 for this for the whole day. I had no idea it was that cheap.
We got lights on both sides.
Everything's gonna be good, or it's not. Stay tuned. I don't know what I'm doing.
Gotta make up some time.
Beautiful, beautiful day in palm trees. Beautiful day to be stuck in traffic.
Well, past 2.5 hours have literally been bumper to bumper traffic because California, but the good news is the trailer is still there and I've hit nobody so far. And Mark's sleeping.
All right. See you guys, see you there.
I see a Hummer H1 up there.
Radio check. How you doing, bro?
Ho ho!
Yo, it is you guys. I mean, how many satin black Hummers are driving down the highways out here?
Yeah, I haven't seen any, but I've been asleep most of the ride, so I wouldn't know.
I saw that. Dave sent me a photo of you asleep with your mouth open.
Hey, man, it's what I do.
We got eyes on you. You're back there. I see you back there.
Hummer looks ridiculous, by the way.
We're about to reveal the car that has mysteriously disappeared off the channel. It's got big power.
Huge power.
It's supercharged.
It is supercharged.
And we had a lot of fun with this car.
The most fun.
And we've done so many mods to this car.
Yes.
I can't believe this car has been abandoned in this lot.
This was your dream car at one point, right?
It was my dream car at one point, Mark.
And I bought it. Cash.
It was a bank draft.
Cash. Sight unseen. And here it is. under this tarp, one of the most historic daily driven exotics vehicles ever to grace your presence on this channel. Can you even imagine what is under this tarp? I have not touched this car in 4 long years.
Dude, nostalgia right here.
Nostalgia. Are you guys ready for the big car reveal? Mark, are you ready?
I am. I've never seen this car.
Please reveal the missing link from daily driven exotics. 3, 2, 1. Yeah. The S55 supercharged AMG 101 Roadster. If you don't remember, we cut the roof off of this car in Alex Choi's mom's garage.
Yeah, the stalls all. Before we did a video one night, so we destroyed this car. It was a lot of fun.
And this was, no bullshit, a dream car of mine. I said that when I bought it, August Luxury Motor Cars. The guy brought it in because he needed to sell it for cash. And I couldn't believe my eyes that this guy was in front of me with an S55. Dave isn't the only person that actually likes luxury cars. I actually wanted one of these really bad. I drove this car from Canada to LA.
Really?
And this car is what saved Dave when Dave had his accident with his manual Gallardo and he got hit and the car got totaled. This is what I was driving. So I turned around and I ran up the hill to see a totaled Lamborghini and a cop insulting my best friend in his dream car.
Yeah, he wasn't very happy that man.
No. So a California Highway Patrol officer insulted my best friend and his dream car and said the only people who own Lamborghinis are, play the clip.
Typically the guys that buy them are assholes because you got that much money to blow on a car. I mean.
That's right. Then Dave rode shotgun with me in the S55 all the way to California.
And this car was mint.
Dude, this car was
mint. It was maintained. It was a gorgeous car. Time has not been kind on this interior. Remember this?
The wall tap.
The wall tap.
Play the clip. So many memories, man. So many memories. Now, this car has, is it an air ride suspension?
Yeah, so it has a full air suspension, airmatic they call it. We actually replaced the compressor just before I cut the roof off.
But why is it slammed to the ground?
Well, because it's controlled by the electronics. Over time, it'll sit down. When you start it, it'll power back up.
So the issue we have is the battery's dead.
Yep, the body control module is under that seat and it's completely soaked. It controls the ignition, the seat belts, the lights, all that shit.
You gotta get one of those and a battery and this thing might turn on.
I don't know.
Can you pop the hood? This is a V8 compressor. So that's supercharged AMG motor, hand built in Germany. But look at this, this thing is dumped right now. It actually looks hilarious. There you go.
Supercharger race.
Oh, look at this. Supercharged.
Who built it?
You can actually see who built this and when.
Kautz Blass, my man.
That's so cool. So the question is, now what? Worst case scenario, we turn this into like a beater.
Put it in the cop car.
A bigger beater. Or we get it running and get world famous Formula Drift champion, Michael Assa.
Michael Assa.
To cut the rest of this off, cut all this, level it all out, grind it all down, strip the interior out, put some race seats in it,
so
put a cage in it.
It'd be fun.
And go to Willow Springs and see if Mark can do a wall tap.
Oh yeah.
Would you love to see Mark do a wall tap in this?
No, that's a horrible idea.
Maybe we add nitrous?
What do you think's in there?
Well, it's open now.
AMG power.
I am missing a duffel bag with some shoes in it. I wonder if it's back here. I
love. Are you serious?
Bag.
Okay, you got the key?
You know what to do?
There Mercedes.
Here we go. Okay, where is it?
You're on your own, Mark.
Did you find it?
Oh, there we go. All right.
There you go. By the way, this is the fine gentleman who runs this establishment.
How you guys doing?
Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thank you.
California Collision Center here in
Oceanside. Come see us.
These guys are great. They have some really cool stuff, by the way. This insane Cadillac. They got a lot of Amazon box trucks. Shout out to Amazon. We love you guys.
Thank you. 4 years. 4 years.
The worst we can do is give you a shout out at this point. Dave's been in contact with this gentleman. I had no idea this thing was here, really. Dave surprised me and was like, hey, by the way, we still have a car. Look at this. This is nostalgic. Presley was riding in this car when it had a roof.
Oh, wow.
Before we cut it off.
Yeah.
And she used to ride on a booster seat. These booster seats are from my Maserati. Dude, these are from my Maserati that I bought before my Gallardo. And what do you got there? Saws off.
Oh, yeah.
That's part of what cut this roof off.
Who's hungry?
Oh, no way.
Come on.
There's no way.
How much?
not gonna happen.
This is the exhaust from when we straight piped
it. Oh, it is straight piped. Forgot.
When we straight piped it. Oh, we just got the exhaust in here. Okay, this is just a disaster. Let's close this up.
Dude, this is the Hummer.
That's from our first Hummer.
From our first Hummer. It ripped off when we were off-roading it.
So many memories with this car. Let's get this thing on the trailer. Let's get it back
to the DDHQ, and we're gonna figure out what we're gonna do with it. And I wanna hear in the comments what you guys want us to do with the car. Do we gut it and turn it into some crazy, wild shenanigans vehicle with a cage and all that? Take the motor and transmission out of it and transplant it into something else? Or do we just say screw it and drive over with the Hummer?
Oh my God, the Hummer's here right now.
Okay, let's get it on the trailer.
Oh, all there right. we go.
I actually kick all my doors.
No, that's soft close.
Soft close. All right, these gentlemen are amazing.
Let's have that.
Oh, it's an S55 drift car.
See this vehicle getting on this trailer.
I guarantee you it will be on this trailer. Now you guys getting it off, you're on your own. But I'll get it on.
I have an idea. It's a really bad one. It's plugging a destroys it. Gonna want to go anywhere. Getting it off is gonna be absolute chaos, destruction, I promise you.
Six dudes go to great lengths to putting it on a trailer.
Chris.
Hold on. Not even close. You don't even have the tire on the rear. That's the end of the trailer. This is still on the ramp.
We're gonna take the bumper off now to get it on the trailer, like I promised you. We got this.
In a world where an AMG won't make it on a trailer.
I actually had to pull the bumper off. By we, I mean my friends here. There we go.
That's it.
Made it. She's in.
This is a bad idea.
I honestly don't know how it's gonna come off.
Against all odds, six men defy gravity. We get an AMG S55 onto a trailer. All right, little photo shoot opportunity. Shout out again to California Collision Center
for holding on to our junk for 4 years.
Did I just say you were holding my junk? Dave's got the Hummer and the S55 ready to rock and roll.
See you guys back at the DDHQ.
Boom.
That's probably an awful idea.
Yeah. Keep going. Yeah, keep going.
So we wanted to do this, obviously, with some light. So we waited till the next day. Now we have the awful job of trying to do what six guys did, but the reverse. It's hooked over the front of the trailer. The rear wheels don't roll. And Dave and I have to come up with a plan to take it off.
We are just tying the car down to a solid structure.
Hope this was built properly.
And we're gonna give it a yank with the Hummer. Are you tying it? Or are you? What are you doing with that?
Don't film me.
That's a mess. That's a mess.
So all you want to do is the trailer.
No more planning. No more planning. Like, no more planning. Just execution.
Yes, like that.
And it would like.
Oh, yes. That is the ultimate goal.
I just don't know if it's going to happen just like that.
Okay, Eric, you're with me. You're my radio man, okay?
Roger that.
So we've got three cameras running. Make sure you capture how you do it perfectly. This will be a training guide for tow truck drivers everywhere.
One strap.
Hey, what could possibly go wrong?
Oh my God.
All right. Stay tuned. I'm actually nervous right now.
Keep going. Tension, stop. Okay, you got tension. Oh, your back wheels are off. It's doing a reverse front out. Keep coming. Okay, you hit the wall. Now run it. Got it. Where's he going? Dude, that was perfect.
Yeah.
That actually went amazing.
Yeah, that was smooth.
We lost a bit of the front end here. That's no big deal. You can patch that up. Okay, the most important part. How's the trailer look? Dude, the trailer's fine, man.
I've never been this happy before.
I have a really bad idea. Wanna go for a ride in it?
You can drag it around now. So we need to get that strap. So we got the Hummer and just push it forward a little bit for me so we can get the strap out.
All right.
Good. Dude, hop up and see this.
We need a tail light. Get the rear wheels off the ground.
Thank you. Thank you. All right, now get the strap off. Somehow. Oh, dude, you hit the tail light. That's coming out of your salary.
That pisses me off. That ruined a perfectly good intentional bumper scuff. Now I have an accidental tail light damage.
Yeah, that's all good. We can fix that. And then over here, unfortunately, you backed into the pole on the trailer and it had a little bit of a contact in the corner.
Okay, now what?
I don't know. I never thought that far ahead into it.
Well, we have to undo this, strap it to the front, take the trailer off, and we need to drag this somewhere.
Yeah.
Like PCH?
Some better days. Old school GoPro mount. What's wild is I was the last person to drive this car when we cut the roof off at Alex's garage in 2019. I'm the one that had the balls to drive it with safety glasses on. Went for a rip, then went into storage, and now it's here today for its final drive. Horn's not working. Yeah, I'm good to go. Final drive in the S55, a car that I've grown to love over you. Jesus! Remember, I have no brakes.
What's the worst that could happen?
A YouTube battle thumbnail. What's up, ladies? Yeah, it's an S-Class, no big deal. I want to brake. It's an AMG. It's such a weird feeling. We're gonna lose a skate for sure. Oh my god! He's going way too fast. I gotta brake it. No, don't brake! Oh, sh**. I hit the hammer up. Dude, there's no damage on it.
Guys, that was so fun.
Thank you.
There's no way any of this is working.
Bro, they made the pyramids. Come on, man.
Is this how they did pyramids?
This dude just referenced this to the pyramids. That's actually true, they did make the pyramids. Hey, do you guys know how they did that? I'd love to know in the comments. Can you please comment below?
If you were there, comment below.
If you were there.
Tell us your firsthand experience.